General Walker's death, General Matthew Ridgway is greeted by South Korean officers as he arrives at the front to assume command of United Nations field forces. With hundreds of thousands of Chinese and North Korean Reds pouring down from the hills, the capital city of Seoul was evacuated. Outnumbered by overwhelming waves of communists, the troops sought new positions in an effort to halt the Red Tide. As they withdrew, warships and transports stood by at Incheon for evacuation. Seoul was left in ruins. Even civilian refugees helped to fire the abandoned towns so that no possible advantage remained to aid the communist invaders. Masses of South Koreans sought safety behind UN lines. These pictures of Russian jet planes are from newsreels captured in Korea. These are the latest Soviet fighter planes, including MIGs and Yaks, which have helped spur the drive of the Reds. But United States Panther jets and the 670-mile-an-hour Sabre jet have been giving the Red Sky Raiders more than they can send. This Russian specimen really takes it on the chin in a dogfight with a United States jet near Manchuria. The superior firepower of the Yank gunners sounds the death knell for the Red Fighter, which goes down at 6,000 feet. The invader still faces a hard-hitting opponent. General Eisenhower confers with Secretary Acheson before leaving to take over as commander of the European Defense Forces.
As of now, I, of course, have no specific plans and ideas as to what is going to develop. I know only two things for certain. The first, that this is a venture, an organizational effort to preserve the peace and to give to all of our people the feeling of tranquility and confidence that they deserve in a free country. And secondly, it can be successful only if the people of all countries, our own and the populations of every single country making up the Atlantic Union, join in the effort wholeheartedly, without stint, and with readiness to sacrifice for success.